All right, so here we are outside in the road. My name's Simon Miller. This is Gerald, the fitness mascot. We're going to cover his eyes. I'm going to close my eyes, and I'm just going to cross the road without looking, because sometimes people go to the gym and they have no plan, so what's the difference? So here we go. We're going to go across the road, eyes closed. Here we go. A-hole here. Thank you very much for joining me once again here on my YouTube channel. Stand up, Gerald. It's the fitness mascot. If you don't know, don't worry about it. Either way, it's all good. Sometimes there are things that happen in the gym when you are lifting weights, when you are trying to be fit, that you need to worry about. And I get it. You don't, because you don't want to worry about it. And you kind of hope that things are just going to right themselves. I do that all the time. My hood is up right now because I want to be warm. So I'm hoping when I put my hood up, maybe I'll get warm when I could just go and turn the heating on. It doesn't make any sense. But we did a video probably a few months ago about 8 gym problems you don't need to worry about. And somebody said, well, what about the ones I do need to worry about? Aren't they more important? And I was like, that is a great, great point to make. So that's what we're going to do right now. Roll it. We're just going to carry on. So number 8 is hitting a plateau or stop seeing progress. Now, really, this can be the worst thing that can happen to you when you go to the gym. And I don't want to ruin your day. What's that, Gerald? That's right. It is going to happen. Unless you are some kind of superhero and you are constantly ahead of the game and you're constantly understanding where your body's going to be in 4 to 6 to 8 to 12 weeks, eventually you're going to realize, wait, I'm not putting on the size, or I'm not losing the fat, or again, you just hit a plateau. You've hit a brick wall and you may as well start smashing your head into it. Now, the key to all of this is, one, to accept that it's happened and understand that it's no bad thing, you're now learning. But two is just to make sure you change things up. And you can change things up in so many areas. I totally do this all the time, so I get it. When you get into a routine, when you're lifting weights, you kind of just want to stick to it. I get it. Maybe this is just more pertinent to me, but it's true. I'm like, well, I'm kind of think it's going the right, bum, bum, bum. And it takes somebody that's got a real knack for these things to take a step back and look at yourself and go, actually, you're not making the kind of gains, or looking at the scale, or doing whatever the hell you decide to do to make a determination about these things. So do not be afraid to change it. At the same time, don't change it too early. We've talked about that. But you don't have to do it in all the usual ways. You can change your split. Maybe if you're doing push-pull legs rest, push-pull legs rest, which is my favorite. Maybe you can change it to back and biceps, chest and triceps, shoulders, legs, or some kind of thing like that for a couple of months and see how you get on. Maybe you need to be doing more cardio. Maybe you need to be doing less. Maybe your training's actually going all right and you're getting DOMS and, you know, you're ticking all the boxes and you're feeling good, but your diet sucks, right? Maybe your diet is now turned its back on you, so maybe you need to drop some calories. Maybe you need to add some calories in. I know that sounds crazy, but sometimes if you eat too little food, your body is not going to operate in the way that it needs to because you are a machine. Do not forget this. You are a car. And if you don't put enough fuel in your car, eventually you will, you know, it's not going to work as well as when you have a full tank. So don't worry about it. Accept that it's going to happen. Always remember that going to the gym is trial and error. I know that sucks. That's not how you want to live your life. You don't live your life, you don't cross the road with trial and error. You don't close your eyes and go, well, let's hope I don't get hit. You're able to actually do more with the situation. But alas, when it does come to lifting weights or whatever you want to call it, this is just what we have to do. So keep an eye on these things. And that's why you need to document and journal stuff. If you open your book and you go, oh my gosh, I was doing 140 kilogram. It's amazing. 140 kilogram bench press back in July. But here we are in November. And for some reason, I'm really struggling. I'm doing less reps. You need to address it. You absolutely do. Maybe you need more rest time. Oh no, oh my gosh, rest recovery. What are we going to do? Maybe you're overtraining your chest, which is why it isn't as strong. Make sure you keep an eye on it and make sure you take control. That's what it's all about. Take control. Number 7 is injuries. Once again, much like number 8, you are going to get injured. It may be a niggle. It may be something serious that you need surgery for. Well, what the hell do you do? You are going to worry about it because you're going to be scared about your gains. Always remember muscle memory. The muscle and the brain and the body are incredible tools. They will remember where you were and you'll get back there quicker than it took you to get it in the first place, right? Which is why when we keep getting put in these global pandemic lockdowns, stay calm. Everything's going to be all right. You will get back there as soon as the gym's open again. But when you have a serious injury, there are two things you can do. And I kind of advocate for both. If it's a niggle and it's just kind of annoying you a little bit, work around it, right? Work around it. So if you've got a bad left tricep, just don't work your left tricep. You could work legs. There are things you could do for your back, potentially. You just have to go with that, you know, the classic, if it hurts, don't do it. And make sure that you're icing and compressing and doing all this kind of a stuff. So make sure you take care of yourself. Now, if you have a serious injury where maybe you need surgery or you do need some physio, need some time off, there is you could go back to the gym, right? Let's say you hurt your leg and it needs surgery, Achilles tendon or something like that. You can still go back to the gym. I see people in gyms all the time with crutches and they're working their upper body. And I say, good for them. But there is nothing wrong with deciding that you're just going to take 4 to 6 weeks out of the gym. Yes, you're going to lose some gains. And yes, you're not going to look as good. And that may affect you mentally. Of course, I totally understand that. But it may actually be what your body needs just to rest and recover. Maybe you hurt your Achilles tendon because your body was under so much pressure and it was begging for a rest. I'd never tell you to take 6 weeks off, but maybe it needed a few days here and there. You didn't do it, so now you got to pay a bigger price. Listen to how you feel and take it from there. And I guess the best thing to try and do with injuries is just to prevent them entirely. And the way you can do that is by making sure you're warming up before you work out, just 10 to 15 minutes on a cardio machine. Stretch after you work out to make sure your muscles are nice and supple so they can recover. If you can afford it, go and get sports therapy massages or do ice baths or things like that. These are the things that will actually stop you from getting injured to begin with, right? If we go back into the world of professional wrestling. I love professional wrestling, if you don't know. I am technically a professional wrestler, but I'm not at the moment because it doesn't exist in the UK because of the lockdown. But yeah, if you go listen to a recent interview with Kenny Omega on the Wrestling Observer Radio, he talks about this. His preventatory injury routine takes forever right now. And he even says, I don't want to do that crap. I don't want to stretch. It's boring. But I do it because I understand to do the thing that I'm passionate about, I need to take care of myself. And it's exactly the same with the gym. Remember, when you're not in the gym, there are things you can do to ensure that your gym experience is even better than it was. Foam rolling is a massive one. That's how we'll end this. Get a foam roller and just foam roll yourself twice to three times a week. You look like an idiot. What you're doing is like surfing on ground for some reason, but I promise you that it helps. Number six is that you're not getting enough protein, or more often than not, you're getting too much. This is a massive gym problem because we still are in this world where the idea is you need all the protein to get muscles. And of course you need some protein to get muscles, but you don't need an abundance of it. It's still a calorie at the end of the day, calories in, calories out. Now, this pertains to loads of different things too. I once tried to do a ketogenic diet, right? I thought I'm gonna try all these diets. Everyone's talking about them and celebrating them. And I tried to do keto, but because I'm stupid and I kept my protein too high, so it wasn't carbohydrates or anything like that, I couldn't go ketogenic. And I know because I started pissing on sticks. If you do want to enter a ketogenic diet, you do need to get a keto stick and piss on it. I'm sure there's other ways now, but it's a good way to do it. I never got there, and I only realized afterwards it's because my protein was way too high, so I wasn't able to enter that state. So just make sure your protein is balanced. You can type right in right now, how much protein should I be having? There's an equation out there. I'm not going to talk about it because I get it wrong every time, and then people yell at me in the comments. You can find it in 30 seconds on Google. But obey that. Essentially, if you weigh if you weigh 225 pounds and you get in 225 grams of protein a day, that's a great place to start. So 1 gram per pound of body weight. And do you know what you do? You tie into number eight. Oh, I'm not putting on enough size. Maybe you do need enough protein, right? Maybe a little more protein. But don't just go and have 500 grams of protein a day because it's a muscle builder. Of course it is, but your body can only deal with so much at one time, and the rest, it will shuffle around the place. And it is a massive problem I see. The number one email and message I get, which I massively appreciate for, you're just emailing me asking for fitness advice. Honestly, I feel like a dad. I feel like a dad and I have thousands of children, which means I'm having a great sex life, or a really bad one. I should be practicing safe sex unless I wanted thousands of kids. Don't know how we got here. Yeah, but the number one thing I get is, Simon, should I have this much protein? And it's always like 9 million grams. I'm like, no. You don't need nine. If you weigh 9 million grams of protein, you'll probably just turn into protein. And then what are you going to do? Number five is a more general one, but I thought I want to hammer this home because people still don't listening. A massive gym problem is not having a plan or a goal. It's fine when you first start out because you just have this bread. It's like going into Narnia, right? It's like going into Narnia, the Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe. It's like, oh my gosh, I've gone through the cupboard and now there's all these crazy new things I have to understand. But you can't, where are you going? It's like when you leave your house, you know where you're going. You don't just walk. Hopefully I end up at the supermarket. No, you Google map to the supermarket, and that's what you need to do in the gym. If you're trying to put on size, you need to come up with some kind of goal. It can be a weight goal. It can be a visual goal. If you get a PT, they can set you a bunch of goals. It can just be that you feel a bit better goal, but you need to know what you're doing. So when you go in the gym, you don't just jump from machine, to weight, to nothing, because I see that massively all the time. Somebody will go on the chest press and they'll do one set, and then they're doing calf raises, and then doing squats. Like, this is just an amalgamation of different things. If you go in there and go, today I'm working chest and today I'm working triceps and I'm going to do 4 sets here, I'm going to do 8 exercises here, that's what you will do. It's the same with everything. If you have a work meeting, you go in there prepared. You have to be prepared for the gym. And I promise you, as arduous as that sounds, when you do get into it, you'll actually start enjoying it more because you'll start to see the progress that you need. Of course, again, today I want you to just go for a walk. And you know what happened? You'll get lost and you have to ring the police and they'll be like, are you nine? Like, no, I'm bored and I'm a loser. Number four is lockdown. It's very, very specific to this time of year and what's going on at the moment. But yes, you do need to worry about lockdown, because as soon as the gym shut, I'm going through this right now, your whole plan is going to change. I was actually having some serious momentum for lockdown two. Lockdown two, nobody wanted a sequel, and we got it anyway, came in. And I was prepared because I had my plan from the first lockdown, which is basically lying on my floor and waving 32 kilogram dumbbells above my head and getting mad about it. But you just need to make sure you're prepared for it, because I don't think we're out of this anytime soon, sadly. I hope that we are. And gyms may open and gyms may close. So just make sure you've got everything you need to do a home workout. And you do not need much, right? Honestly, this is what I have. I have a pull-up bar. It's up there. And it turns into like a push-up thing, so I can do that. I have two 32 kilogram dumbbells, which I count as my main weights because they're well expensive. I couldn't afford any more. And I have a bunch of smaller plates that I can put onto, to metal sticks, for lack of a better term, and they go up to around about 20 kilograms. That allows me to superset, and that allows me to do drop down should I so wish. From there, I just work out everything I can. So if I want to do bench press, I lay on the floor, put a cushion behind me for comfort, and I just, smash those dumbbells out. Obviously, my shoulders aren't going to go get much depth because there's a floor there, but that's okay. I'm working on chest. If I need to work shoulder, I get a chair and I can do shoulder presses. If I'm doing triceps, I can just do not forget how important body weight exercises are. You can just put your hands like that, and you can do a close grip bench press, but you're just doing it as a press up. What's this weird thing I'm doing with my shoulder, like the Hunchback of Notre Dame? So that you, as long as you are intense, as long as you really, really push it, there's no reason why you can't work out at home. Legs are really difficult. I struggle to work legs, but even then, you can do body squats, you can hold a couple of dumbbells and you can do dumbbell squats, you can do Bulgarian split squats if you've got a couple of dumbbells, you can do Romanian deadlifts with a couple of dumbbells, so you can get a good workout. Like, but you just, it has to all be there and it has to be all in place, because if you get the lockdown coming in and you don't have the stuff, then you've got to get the stuff. Then it's not going to get to you for 25 days because for some reason people are so slow at delivering. And then you haven't trained for 3 weeks and you're going to lose your momentum. You're going to have to start again. And that's the hardest thing with the gym. This is the other issue with injuries. It's kind of different with injuries because you're so excited to go back to the gym. But how much better is the gym when you're going every day or as much as you can, as opposed to when you haven't gone for a while? Right? So don't do that. Stay on it. Smash it. Number three is losing your motivation and then looking for a quick fix. Right? You look for a quick fix. And that can be many of the things that we've already talked about. But sadly, once again, there's a theme here. But of course it is. It's a video on YouTube. You are going to lose your motivation at one point. It may be because you're tired. It may be because you go through a breakup. It may be because you lose your job or you're having financial struggles. It will usually be something outside of the gym. But you just want to sit on your couch and eat Cheetos in your pants. And then you look down in your pants and you've got the orange stuff and the Cheetos and you look at the nutrition. You're like, how the hell there's so many calories in a bag of Cheetos? This may have happened to me once. Not from a depressing point of view. I went on holiday to America and I bought a bag of Cheetos. Stand up, Gerald. And I bought a bag of Cheetos and I ate the whole thing on my hotel bed. Had a great time. And then I looked at the calories. When I go on holiday, I try not to worry about it. And I was like, flub me, man. No wonder they tasted so damn good. It was like eating drugs. Honestly, it's a bit like being addicted when you lose your motivation. You just have to accept the fact that you have. And then again, re-figure out what your goals are. And then you'll get excited again. And maybe you just need a break from the gym. I mean, it's so difficult now, but maybe you just need to start going for runs on the outside, or maybe you need to go to a boxing club or a wrestling school. You want to go mountain climbing. That's usually what will get you in. Then when you re-find your passion for that, you're like, oh my gosh, if I go to the gym, it will make me even better at this activity, and so on and so forth. But I think the key for me mentioning that is, don't think that everybody that goes to the gym, even the people you see on Instagram, are waking up every day at 6:30 desperate to go to the gym. Of course they're not. That's not how the brain works. Sometimes you're tired. Sometimes you haven't had enough food. Sometimes you're stressed. You are not wanting to go to the gym every time. And if you do find it in that place, always use Simon Miller's approved method, the bald a-holes method, which is day you usually go to the gym for 90 minutes. On the days you don't want to go, just do 30 minutes workout. Tell yourself, I'm just going to do a 30-minute workout, because I guarantee almost every time. After 20 minutes, when your adrenaline's going and you're getting that endorphin rush, you'll be like, well, I'm here now. I may as well finish it. And sometimes they can actually be the best workout of all. Number two is terrible fitness advice. Now, I'm not saying that I give out good fitness advice, but I am saying I try and be transparent and honest as possible. And I think my stuff is good, but I'm putting it on you to go out there and research it and make sure you like what I'm saying. But that's not how YouTube works. There are guys out there, that's why I started this channel, where they tell you, I'll get you abs in 2 days. I'll make you lose 10 pounds in a blink. And you're like, what does that even mean? Some people will say, come give me a hug and you'll be in the best shape ever. You've got to stay away from those people because they're doing terrible, terrible things. But honestly, there is so much of it out there. And how the hell are you supposed to know what is right and what is not right? You can watch Simon Miller's Should You Listen To Them series, which is out there to do that. But again, as sometimes people say, well, why should I listen to you? You just have to be really smart with this stuff, right? You should be getting information, not just from me, but from people like AthleanX, Greg Doucette, I can't think of anybody else now, but there's all buff dudes. There's a ton of fitness YouTubers and books, and hell, you can get the Arnold Schwarzenegger book, which is pretty good. But there's tons of stuff out there, but just make sure you take little bits, apply them to you, but do not expect them to work every time, because you're different to me and I'm different to you and so on and so forth. It goes back to the whole trial and error thing. Make sure you give them time, 4, 8, 6, 12 weeks. But if you're not getting anywhere, just scrub it up to the fact that either A, the person you got it from may be tricking you a little bit and you need to put that in your brain, but also it just may be how your body operates, right? So take care of yourself, take care of each other, and just see how you go on. Number one is a bad diet. Now, I had an argument with somebody on the internet about this the other day, because I don't think they got my point. The phrase is, it's 70% diet and 30% gym in terms of getting in shape. And I'm like, that's absolute nonsense, because I'm not saying it's 50-50, because as this person pointed out, like, yeah, but, you know, I only go to the gym for an hour a day, whereas the temptation of bad food is 95%. I was like, flipping hell, you must be a right joy at parties, Mr. Pedantic over here. My point is this, you can have a perfect diet, but if you try and put on size, you're not lifting right, it's not going to work. And vice versa, if you're smashing in the gym, but you're eating burgers every day, it's not going to work. Diet is usually the worst one. Yes, this guy was right in that sense. So do not underestimate how important it is. You must have heard the phrase, you are what you eat, right? Someone didn't just come up with that. It's because it's true. It doesn't mean you turn into a pineapple if you eat a pineapple. It's not a literal thing, but you know, depending on what you put on your body is how you're going to look. Now, some people can get away with it, yes. Some people have amazing metabolism, just need any kind of sustenance, but you've got to be eating right and you've got to be eating healthy. And again, if you're not seeing the progress that you want, I'd always start with your diet, mostly, because even if you are kind of half-assing it in the gym, at least you're in the gym to begin with, and you'll find your moxie again. But the diet is going to, you know, the diet catches up with you within about a week. You know, you can have a few cheats here and there, that's fine. But if you're eating consistently badly over a 7-day plus period, sooner or later, you're going to start to feel sluggish and that's going to affect your gym session. Then you'll start to see it on the hips and the lips, whatever the hell people say. That's the worst phrase ever, isn't it? A second on the lips, a lifetime on the hips. What are you eating? What are you eating? Like, just pure fat? That doesn't make any sense whatsoever. If you eat pure fat, your body would probably sort it out. But yeah, make sure your diet is on point. I don't mean to overstress it, but it should be not a worry. That's too much of a negative connotation. But it does need to say, you need to sit down one day, if you haven't done this already, and you need to map out everything you're eating. I mean, everything. That condiments, sauces, whatever, salad, and you need to figure out all your macros. Some people just like to focus on a few, but I think it's good to just have it. So figure out your calories, figure out your proteins, figure out your fats, figure out your carbs, and then you can, you know, you know where you're going, right? You can switch. If you want to lose some weight, drop your calories. You want to increase your weight, you can up your calories, and you can see, well, I'm eating too much here, and maybe there's too much in this meal, and you can basically take control of your own destiny. And how cool does that sound? You're taking control of your own destiny. And it's better than Destiny, the video game. That thing's shite. And I regret saying that because now I've wound up with the Destiny fanboys. It's fine. It's just not my cup of tea. But look, they've smashed it for 2 games now. And there'll be a third. Bungie kicking ass. Now, like the video, share the video, subscribe to the channel, hit the bell, ding, ding, so you know when other videos are going live. Please watch other videos, especially from last week. They didn't do as good of views as the other ones. I was really sad. So I'm a very sensitive man. I got merchandise, simonair.bigcartel.com, Instagram and Twitter at simonair316. But more importantly, no matter what you're training today, no matter what your fitness routine, go out there, smash it, kill it with power, and I'll see you soon, as will Gerald.